the miners are working in this lunar landscape. Ugh.
Flashlight in the gloom. On a pre-dawn hike up a volcano, the air is thick with volcanic fumes. Gas masks necessary, the closer we get to the heart of the volcano. The gas creates an incredible effect, blue flames that ripple like ghosts up the volcano walls. At the bottom of the crater, we find this. Indonesian miners digging up the raw sulfur that builds up near vents in the volcano. Ill-equipped workers struggling to cope with the volcanic gas.
So, I'm lucky, I've got a gas mask. This miner, he's just using a fabric stuffed into his mouth.
No masks.
No masks. Hard work, then.
Dawn reveals we're next to a crater lake that's deeply acidic and warm to the touch. When they gather enough sulfur, the miners load up their baskets and begin the long, back-breaking journey out of the crater.
It's an 800-meter hike out of the crater, most of it up a very steep incline. And miners like Mr. Mistati here are carrying from 85 to 100 kilos of sulfur on their backs.
Hauling a man's weight in sulfur up these steep trails to earn the equivalent of just around $12 a day. Excellent pay, he says, for men who would otherwise be impoverished farmers.
This looks like one of the hardest jobs in the world.
This real-life Superman seems to agree. The sulfur will eventually be used to purify sugar and make soap, skin treatments, and even explosives. It is the yellow harvest of a volcano.